What is going on, everybody? Welcome back. MTG here with another episode. And today, I'm here to talk about the iPhone 8 Plus 2 years later. Is it still worth it? So, without further delay, let's dive right in. So let's get the question out of the way. Is it still worth it in 2019, 2 years later, the iPhone 8 Plus? Yes, it's still worth it. Why? The big thing is, this is an Apple device, which means you're going to be getting software updates for at least 3 to 4 years, and the 8 Plus is included. Now you're not going to be getting a bezel-less display like the OnePlus 7 Pro, or even something like the iPhone 10 with a notch. You're getting thick bezels. But the great thing about this is, it has Touch ID, which means you're going to be getting fast and secure unlocking speeds for your phone. Another great feature is the 8 Plus has wireless charging. Now, it's not the fastest, but at least it has that feature. Like I said, you're going to be getting up-to-date software. Right now, the 8 Plus has iOS 12.2, and you're probably going to be getting iOS 13, and you can even look forward to iOS 14. A lot of people refer to me as the Android guy and say, you know, he does not use an iPhone. Well, here's an iPhone, and I'm using it. Yeah, there are some downsides. Everything has their downsides, but I still enjoy using the 8 Plus. Now, the one thing that keeps me coming back to the 8 Plus and any iPhone in general is video quality. Now, I'm recording this video with an Android phone, and the video that I published before this, if you haven't checked it already, it's the Galaxy S8, 2 years later, is still worth it. That video was recorded with an iPhone 8 Plus with this phone, and the quality on that is definitely better than the video quality that I'm recording with an Android phone. That's why you'll hear people saying, for example, Pixel 3 is amazing for its picture quality. You will get the best pictures taken on a smartphone with the Pixel 3, but when it comes to video, a lot of people, actually almost everybody, recommends the iPhone for its video quality. If you're going to vlog with your smartphone or if you're going to take videos like this, iPhone is the way to go. Another great thing is with Apple devices, it's the ecosystem. Everything is connected. Everything is connected. Let's say I get a message on my iPhone, it shows up on my Mac, or it'll show up on an Apple Watch. And that's the greatness of Apple. Everyone, a lot of people use Apple because of the ecosystem. Once you get in the ecosystem, it is pretty tough to leave. And there's no other company out there that does it like Apple. And I give them credit to that. Good job, Apple. And this kind of fits in with the ecosystem. Since there are so many people that use the ecosystem, that use Apple devices, a lot of developers bring out their apps first on iOS devices. And that's the great plus about this too. I have more apps that I can use on iPhone than I can on Android. Of course, Android does have a lot of options as well, but iOS implements the apps better. If your job revolves around social media, you're going to be getting a better layout on iPhone devices, and that's just the truth. Like, iPhone implements social media, and the layout on social media on iPhone and iOS devices are just better in general. Now, the one downside is it charges really damn slow, like insanely slow. It has that lightning cable that Apple needs to really ditch, because everything is USB Type-C now. Android phones, MacBook Pros, even the iPad Pro, they're using USB Type-C. So it's time for Apple to make the switch, and that's kind of a disadvantage with the 8 Plus. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe the iPhone 8 Plus came out with the A11 chip, and it's still blazing fast. It gets the job done smooth, no hiccups, no nothing. Another great thing is iMessage. Now, everyone, and I mean everyone, especially the community around me, everyone uses iPhone, which means iMessage. And when I'm the only person using Android, it kind of sucks. I can't really communicate with everyone and see what everyone else is doing. But when you're using an iPhone, you're on iMessage, it's just so much more convenient. That's pretty much it for this video. The strong suits, like I said, Touch ID, great video quality, wireless charging, and you're getting iOS with at least 4 years of guaranteed updates. Straight from Apple, the first day it comes out, not like Android. And don't forget, it's still, and since it's Apple, it's still pretty fast. It gets the job done. It didn't let me down since day one. So 2 years later, I can still use this. It doesn't have a modern design, but it also doesn't have a bad design either. It still is a good looking device. Anyway, everybody, I hope you guys did enjoy this video. If you did, be sure to comment down below, Superman that like button, and best of all, Superman that subscribe button. Until next time, everybody, and until next video, this is MTG.